Hello, my name is Caroline Coudreau-Parfait. My paper involves the influence of OCR noise on spatial name entity recognition. First, I present you how I build my corpus, and secondly, the difficulties I have with OCR, and in the point 3, 4, 5, I explain how I evaluate stanzai and spacey to name entities recognition tools, and finally my conclusion and perspectives. I work with LTEC corpus. It's a clean version of a French novel of from 19th century. And I build an OCR version of this corpus. For that, I retrieve images from the Galleca website, and I use two OCR with a model, Kraken with Baz model, and Tesseract with Baz and French models. For the name entity recognition, I use Spacey with a large, small, and medium. The difference is because smaller models are trained with smaller data and stanza. And we wonder if how to evaluate the quality of NER results on a noisy OCR corpora. And we try to use a precision recall and F-score. But because a lot of problem of alignment, we prefer use an supervised approach, and I explain later. This slide is just on my information about my corpus. We work with 11 books. It's count 3,195 pages. On this slide, you can see two big difficulties that we can have with the OCR. First, when the text is on two columns, and the second is when you have an illustration with the caption on your page. With Kraken, you can see that Kraken tried to transcript the picture and the caption of the picture in blue, and Tesseract just tried to transcript the picture caption on the original text. But in this example, we can see that Kraken have some difficulty to manage the two column text. In green, you can see the first column text, and in black, the second column text. And you can see that there is some difficulty for have the good reading ways. But Tesseract, with Tesseract, it's okay. This slide shows us the distance between the reference text and the OCR version of this text. When the dot is really close to the one, it's because something went wrong. And when the dot is really close to the zero, it's okay. And we can see in these two examples that maybe something went less good with Kraken than with Tesseract. It's better with Tesseract. On this slide, you can see some example when you use Spacey and Stanza on OCR version. You can see that the NER tools succeed to recognize Rue Saint-Honoré, even if it misses the accent on the E. But when two words to indicate a location as la rue means the street, stanza and these two words are stuck stanza don't recognize the terms, but Spacey recognize just Saint-Honoré. It's maybe because we can think that the lexical context have an impact more than the lexic, the vocabulary. On this slide, you can see some example of mislabeling even in the reference. The first, it's an example with the first name is labeling like a location. And in the second table, you can see that it's a verb that Spacey Small takes like as a location. And it's an example why we have some problem to calculate, to evaluate our output with precision recall and F-score, because for the machine, these examples are too positive. But for us, as with a human gaze, we know it's a false true positive, it's a false positive. It's another example of the difficulty precision recall and F measure. It's a problem of entity linking, because you can see that on the different OCR version, you have a different misspelled word. Guadalajara, 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 for Guadalajara. And how you explain to the machine that it's the same word. For the moment, we have no response. On this slide, we begin to use an unsupervised approach with a Venn diagram, and we calculate the intersection. You can see in the red circle the true positive, and in the green circle the false positive, and between in the intersection, the true positive are similar on the OCR output and the reference output. The difference between the number of the results with Kraken and Tesseract is not really big. Maybe we should consider that in case of Kraken, we have a false positive. So it's true positive with a problem of entity linking, like the example of Guadalajara. Okay, on this other slide, we want to compare the small model of Spacey and the Spacey large. And if you use a Spacey model small, it appears you have more noise, maybe more false positive. Why? It's maybe because the model is less trained and retrieves more words, because in doubt, he prefer bring something. Okay, the problem is not only the input data. but the model we use, but we can consider the difference between the intersection for Kraken and Tesseract isn't so big. Finally, on this slide, we show you that there is something went wrong with Kraken, because the cosinus metric show us a real distance between the NER output for the reference and the NER output for the OCR. It's maybe because cosinus show us you have a lot of thing of your, you have a lot of noise, you have a lot of false positive with your OCR output. And we can see that Jacquard show us that something went wrong almost all the time. It's maybe because Jacquard show us it miss so a lot of thing in your intersection. To conclude, we can see that not all OCR errors are equal, and we have shown you that for the NER tools, a spelling mistake is not the same thing that a lexical context mistake, and we try to show us the different difficulties we have, and one of important is the link entity issues, because we as a human we can see the noise and we can do something with noise, but what happened when it missing information on the output, and we see to the choice of the distance measurement is not, it's really important because we see that cosinus underestimate the distance between the NER result of reference version and the OCR version, and Jacquard show us that it miss a lot of things in your results. My perspective is to train a NER model on noisy data, what happened when I trained my tool with noisy data? It maybe changed nothing. We explore that, and finally, I try to represent my different NER output on the maps, maybe to represent the real difference between the reference and the OCR version. Thank you very much.